This zone is all about how you participate in the economy and focuses on economic principles that relate to you as an individual. This exhibit explores many of the different ways that you participate in the economy. While they might not all relate specifically to you, there is information you are sure to find interesting. For this example, let's take a look at some economic facts about taking vacations. Looking at this first fact, the vacation travel industry is a very lucrative one, accounting for $792 billion in spending in 2019. With all the money being spent on vacation travel, there have to be people working at all the various destinations. There are so many, in fact, one out of every 10 U.S. jobs depends on travel and tourism. As much as people want to take vacations, sometimes it's just not that easy to get away from work. Did you know more than half of workers left vacation time unused in 2018, accounting for 768 million unused vacation days? And when people are able to get away from work to travel, 4 out of every 5 trips within the U.S. are done for leisure purposes. Throughout the museum, you will see these oversized words that introduce different topics. Here you can learn about scarcity. What is scarcity, you might ask? It is simply when there are not enough resources to produce everyone's wants. Because of this, you have to make choices. You might really want a new phone and a new bike. Let's say you have been working and saving your money, but only have enough money to buy either the phone or the bike. Scarcity of resources means you must choose. The terms physical capital and human capital may sound complex, but they are actually fairly simple. Physical capital represents the tools, equipment, and machinery used to produce goods and services. Let's say you run a lawn care business. The lawnmower and trimmer you use on the job are examples of physical capital. Human capital relates to the physical capital as it is the education, skills, and talents that people use to make goods and services. Thinking back to the lawn care business, you first have to learn how to use the lawnmower and trimmer before you become good at operating them. The panels on the exhibit show many examples of physical and human capital, such as how music lessons relate to discipline, goal achievement, and confidence. Let's now learn about another economic concept, opportunity cost, what you give up when you make a decision. Using our previous example, if you decided to buy a new phone instead of a bike, the bike is your opportunity cost. When famous economist Milton Friedman said, "There's no such thing as a free lunch," he was actually saying that there is always a cost, an opportunity cost. Someone is paying for the lunch even if there is no cost to you. By accepting a free lunch, you may be obligating yourself to something in the future. You can see more examples of opportunity cost in the next exhibit called What Do You Want? Here you are presented with 2 different options, and you have to make a decision of which activity you would rather do. In this example, let's look at the choices a teenager might have to make. For these questions, there is no wrong answer. It's all about your preference. While not all of our choices are monetary choices, the first question is, which would you rather do? Mow the lawn and earn $20, or go to the movies and spend $10? Let's choose to mow the lawn. As you see, by making this choice, you not only earn $20 from working, but you now have $30 more than you would have if you had spent $10 going to the movie. The next choice might be a bit tougher. Would you rather attend a friend's going away party or keep your commitment, volunteering at a food pantry? Let's choose volunteering. As you can see, there isn't a wrong answer. You gave up attending the party and stuck to your commitment, helping the community. This next exhibit shows that your education level affects how likely someone is to have a job, as well as how much money you may earn weekly because of your education. Using the slider in the middle, you can choose different education levels and see the unemployment rate and median weekly earnings associated with that level. So what do you notice? The bars located at the bottom of the slider are for someone with less than a high school diploma. You can see the bar on the left is pretty large. What this means is, at that level of education, there is a higher unemployment rate. The bar on the right shows the weekly earnings, meaning the weekly pay is fairly low. Now, as the slider moves up, the bars on the left get smaller, and the bars on the right get larger. This shows a direct relationship between more education and higher pay. As people achieve higher levels of education, they have an easier time finding a job, and their median weekly earnings increase. As you acquire more skills and knowledge through education and training, also known as human capital, an employer is more willing to hire you and also willing to pay you a higher wage. Now let's go to the next exhibit. Here you will learn about how your decisions can affect how much money you have in savings or how much debt you may have in the future. This exhibit has several different scenarios, such as starting a savings account or the real cost of buying a couch with a credit card. Let's take a look at purchasing a car. After selecting what type of car you would like to buy, you can adjust loan interest rates and monthly payments to see how they affect the overall price of a car. It's important to recognize that when you take out a loan to buy a car, you must repay the amount of the loan plus the amount of interest charged over the life of the loan. When it comes time to purchase an actual car, it's important to know that you can't choose the interest rate like in our exhibit. Your interest rate is determined by your credit history. Also, by making a down payment on the car and being willing to make a larger payment each month, you can reduce the total cost of the car. Let's take a quick break to see what you have learned. Thank you.